Harvey Proctor has always been a controversial Conservative in Parliament, a disciple of Enoch Powell on race and immigration issues. But in recent months, his headlines have featured allegations of spanking sessions and tales of Arabian Nights. His speech to the right-wing Swinton Circle at Westminster blasted army plans to introduce ethnic monitoring of recruits from April 5. The army can't say how many black or Asian soldiers there are because they don't count them. Cynics say it wouldn't take long. Harvey Proctor claimed that national defence was too important for the meddlers of the race relations industry and, citing Muslims, questioned the ideological commitment of ethnic soldiers.
In certain circumstances, I think that's possibly true, although I also remarked in my speech as to their loyalty with regard to the action that took place in the Falkland Islands and made the point that historically we have always had black and brown soldiers and seamen in our armed forces, and I'm not against that. It was pressing a certain ratio of black and brown soldiers, sailors and airmen into our armed forces that I'm against.
And how would you react to the suggestion that your worries are based on racism rather than rationale?
Oh, that is a smear. I'm used to that and other smears. It's water off a duck's back.
Conservative Central Office and the Ministry of Defence considered his speech unworthy of comment. The West Indian Ex-Servicemen's Association saw it as an insult to Commonwealth soldiers who fought and died for Britain. The Commission for Racial Equality said Mr. Proctor's wrong. Ethnic monitoring doesn't mean ethnic quotas. They're illegal.
Nobody suggests that there should be quotas reintroduced into this country, but we do want people recruited on merit and equal opportunity policies that are fairly judged and monitored. That's what ethnic monitoring is.
Privately, Tory MPs are cringing at this latest outburst from the colleague most regard as a major embarrassment. Will he resign?
No, I'm not going to resign. I've made my position about the gutter press quite clear. I've denied those allegations. The matter is in the hands of my solicitors. And if you have a dog, you don't bark yourself, you know.
He survived one attempt to oust him from Billericay. There could be another at his party's annual general meeting later this month. David Bellin, Thames News.
Every part of the grounds.